Today we'll be talking about capacitors and charge balance over a capacitor. We use capacitors in switch systems like DC-DC converters quite a bit, and we'll be looking at systems where they have a level of ripple, the voltage over the capacitor. It may be going up and back down, but over a period, a cycle where it repeats, it will come back to the same value and then repeat after that. So Valerie has set up a demo over there and we're gonna go look at that. So Valerie set up this really nice demo for us. Thank you, Valerie. And we have our water here that is representing a capacitor, our capacitor cup. And over one cycle, we may put charge into the capacitor and we may take some charge out. So if during the cycle, we take some charge, which is represented as water here, we put it into our capacitor, we see that the voltage level, the level of water, is increased during the cycle. But during that same cycle, we will take some charge out, and some of that charge will be delivered to the load. Overall, in that cycle, we have the exact same level of water, so the exact same voltage. So in a steady state system, charge coming in and charge coming out have to be equal, they have to be balanced. Otherwise, the voltage here will start to increase or to decrease. Now let's look at the math behind that concept of charge balance. So if we have our base equation for a capacitor, I equals C dV dt, we're going to play with that a little bit and see what we can determine about the charge. So first, let's move dt over to this side. IC dt equals C dVc. That looks kind of weird. Let's integrate both sides. And we're going to integrate over this period because we only care about one period. It's repeating, so after that it's going to be the same. So we're going to integrate from 0 to t. Now, we can see here we have the same expression, the integral from the current into the capacitor, so into or out of the capacitor, over time. And then we have this thing. We can simplify this part. We can take the C out because the C is going to be constant. And we're left with the integral from 0 to t of dVc. This we can simplify, break down, because we know we're operating over a period, and we know that there's going to be a point here, Vc of t, and we're going to look at this point too, Vc of 0. So let's just rewrite this. Now, this will simplify because it's just a 1, so this becomes Vc of t minus Vc of 0. And notice this is the beginning point and end point. If this system is in average steady state, meaning that the average value over a period is not changing, it means that from the starting point to the end point, those have to be the same values. So the difference between this has to be 0. So if we're in average steady state, some people call that DC steady state, same meaning. This has to be 0, this value. If this is 0, C is some value, it means that this part also has to be 0. So in this state, this also must equal 0. This is called the charge balance part. We can then take this, and we notice that this relates to the average value of the current. So the average value, IC, is defined as 1 over t, the integral from 0 to t of the current. This is the same value. And we know if we're in this state, if we're average steady state, this value must be 0. That's the same as this. This must be 0, which means that the average value must be 0. The important part to remember is that in systems that are average steady state, most of the ones that we work with, the average capacitor current must be 0. If the average capacitor current is not 0, or you're putting more charge in than you're taking out, or the opposite, it means that the voltage in the capacitor will be increasing or decreasing, and this would be considered a transient in the system. So for nice stable systems, you want the average capacitor current to be zero.